annual status of education report, ACER report 2019. It was recently released by the NGO called Pradham. Published ACER report 2019, early years is the theme. About ACER. ACER is a sample-based household survey and the largest citizen-led survey in India. It is an annual survey that aims to provide reliable annual estimates of children's schooling status and basic learning levels for each state and rural districts in India. Every year since 2005, ACER has reported on the ability to do basic reading and arithmetic tasks for children in the age group of 5 to 16 age group in the rural India. In 2017, ACER Beyond Basics focused on the abilities, experiences and aspirations of youth in the age group of 14 to 18 years of age group. ACER 2019 survey highlights, focusing on the early years. What are early years? The early years is known to be the most important stage in the cognitive and the motor and social and emotional development in the human life cycle. The early years, ACER collects data on schooling or preschooling status of the children in the age group of 4 to 8. It explores selected competencies categorized in the four domains: early language acquisitions, early numeracy skills, cognitive abilities, social and emotional learning. Key highlights and takeaways. First thing we have to know about what is the preschool education and care that status in India. The Right to Education Act proposes that state governments make the necessary arrangements for early childhood care and education for all the preschool age children, that is 3 to 6 years. The draft National Educational Policy 2019 underlies the importance of early childhood education and prescribes the guidelines for providing the pre-primary education. However, India Early Childhood Education Impact Study 2017 presents evidence that young children do not follow the enrollment trajectories outlined by the policy. So the key takeaways in the ACER report 2019 are the status of preschool and school enrollment patterns among the young children in the age group of 4 to 8. More than 90% of the young children in this age group are enrolled in some type of educational institution. Status of children in early primary grade, that is standard 1 to 3. In the variation in the age distribution, which is the weirdest in the standard 1, decreases in each subsequent grade. Age distribution is decreasing in each subsequent grade, and other children continue to do better than the younger ones on every task. Private schools performing better than the government schools. They have a learning advantage on all the crucial factors such as age distribution in the grade 1, home factors such as affluence, mother's education and some baseline abilities that children enter grade 1. With this, they expose the children to school-like curricula even before they have entered the school. Role of mother education is important. Among the pre-primary age section, children with mothers who are completed 8th or few years of schooling are more likely to be attending the Anganwadis or government or pre-primary classes, whereas like peers whose mothers studied beyond the elementary stage are more likely to be enrolled in the private LKG or UKG classes. What are the concerns? The concerns are gender gaps. It is visible among the young children of age group of 4 to 8, with more girls than boys enrolled in the government institutions and more boys than girls enrolled in the private institutions. It is clearly seen. Cognitive skills. At the age group of 5, large proportion of children is unable to do all the activities. Moreover, children from less advantaged homes are affected disproportionately. Difference in the age distribution. Right to Education Act 2009 RTE mandates that the children should enter the standard 1 at the age of 6. However, 4 out of every 10 children in the standard 1 are younger than 5 or older than 6. Children in the standard 1 in the government schools are younger than those in the same grade in the private school. Mismatch with the curriculum expectations. Children's skills and abilities improve in each subsequent grade, but huge jump between curriculum expectations at each grade means that standard 3 and their early language and the numeracy outcomes are already well behind the curriculum expectations. For example, 41% of the students in the standard 1 can recognize two-digit numbers, while 72.2% of the students in the standard 2 can do so. But according to the NCERT's specification of learning outcomes, children are expected to be able to recognize the numbers up to 99 in the standard 1 itself. So there is a clear mismatch with the curriculum expectations with the help because of this age difference, age distribution. Poor condition in Anganwadis. Why the poor condition in Anganwadis? Children in the Anganwadis do worse than private preschool children on cognitive as well as early language tasks. For instance, 14% children in the Anganwadis could recognize letters or more compared to 52.9% in the private preschools. What are the recommendations? Focus on play-based activities. Children's performance on tasks requiring cognitive skills is strongly related to their ability to do early language tasks and early numeracy tasks. This suggests that focusing on play-based activities that build memory, reasoning, and problem-solving abilities is more productive than an early focus on the content-based knowledge. Reworking. So, focusing on a play-based activities that builds the memory, reasoning, and problem-solving abilities is more productive than the early focus on content-based knowledge. Reworking of curriculum and activities. This is urgently needed for the entire age band from 4 to 8. Cutting across all types of preschools, regardless of whether they are run by the private or government, the curriculum activities must change. Strengthening the existing network of Anganwadi centers, finding the ACER 2019 findings, make a clear case for strengthening the early childhood education centers so that they implement appropriate school readiness activities. Revisit state and national norms for age of entry to school. ACER shows clearly that performance is closely related to children's age. Permitting underage children into primary grades puts them at a learning disadvantage, which is difficult to overcome. ACER data shows that 27% of all the children in the standard 1 are under age 6. Breadth of the skills is important, and focusing too early on formal subject learning is counterproductive. ACER 2019 data shows a focus on activities that strengthen cognitive skills rather than the subject learning in the early years may generate substantial benefits in terms of children's future learning. Need to streamline the curriculum at a preschool stage so that all the preschool focus on activities that build cognitive and early literary numeracy skills is important.